All right, we know this about Minnesotans. You all know how to be generous, and we're here to get the word out so you can do your part to help children fight cancer and help their families too. A campaign to help the New Orleans Saints punter Thomas Morstead's charity. All right, but before that, you can see it's at $102,000 right now. We need to back up and start this story from where it began. So you're all in the know. The fundraising campaign started after the win on Sunday night.
That's right. Morstead, who was injured early on in the game, pretty badly actually, not only did he play the whole darn game, but he showed some sportsmanship at the end. Lindsay Sievert shows us how his actions now are helping others right here in Minnesota.
An act of sportsmanship in the moment of victory was not lost upon Vikings fans.
Think twice about it.
Saints punter Thomas Morstead was the first Saints player to come back to the field for the point after touchdown, even though he was in extreme pain from tearing cartilage on his rib cage from an earlier tackle.
You know, they needed 11 guys, and so I went out, and that was it.
Until a Vikings fan posted to Reddit encouraging other fans to show appreciation by giving to Morstead's foundation, What You Give Will Grow, a charity boosting child life departments at children's hospitals. More than 250 fans gave more than $3,000.
If we can get, you know, more people like you, the world would be a better place.
But what no fan expected.
Well, thank you very much.
Morstead would punt donations right back here, giving to Children's Minnesota Child Life.
Treats their, on the emotional side of what they're having to deal with, you know, it's hard to explain to a three-year-old or a six-year-old why they're getting needles put in their body every day.
You are exactly right. We know this impacts. It impacts length of stay. It impacts how kids experience pain, how they manage stress better in the hospital.
Joy Johnson-Lind oversees Child Life at Children's.
Gratitude. Although it was kind of originated out of this, you know, highly competitive sporting event, it really puts it in perspective to the impact of kids and families.
To Minnesotans and to Morstead, another victory.
Just thank you to everybody who donated.
When children win.
And I'll give you a hoot at.
Morstead said all the donations he receives this week will go to Children's Minnesota, and the hospital tells us every dollar will go to a child's bedside. He also said if he hit $100,000, he would fly here to Minneapolis during the week of the Super Bowl to personally deliver the check.
Well, get ready to get on a plane, Mr. Morstead. Here's where the total stands. As we said, the Vikings and Saints tweeted out in the last hour, each of those teams are going to donate $10,000 to put you over the top, Thomas Morstead. You, however, can still donate to the cause if you want. All of you watching at home, we have a story and a link up on care11.com, and we will welcome him with open arms.
I love this story for so many reasons. First of all, for people who have only lived in Minnesota, not have lived anywhere else, I can't tell you how philanthropic and phenomenal this community is. You might not know it if you haven't been anywhere else, but there's something special about Minnesota, and this proves it. And there's something special about this player, this young man and his family. I love this story so much, I can't even stand it.
God bless, we haven't had you on the show to cry for a while.
I know!
It's so great.
I didn't, only a little bit.
You cried.
Let's skull right now.
I love you, Mr. Morstead. Let's do the skull.
Well, we're keeping the Vikings theme going because here at Care 11, we just can't get enough of those skull chants created by the cute students.